be Harvey, I think. And I believe the call will be interference. Yeah, there he goes, Doug Harvey, number two. We'll wait for the official announcement. There are 2 seconds remaining in the penalty to Bonnet. And the crowd is roaring. We want story.
Canadien penalty, Doug Harvey, 2 minutes for interference. The time, 11 minutes and 53 seconds.
11 minutes and 53 seconds. You see Donnie Marshall talking to Jacques Plante. As the Leafs have the two-player advantage, but Bonin will be back in 2 seconds. So we have Regan, number 8, Armstrong, 10, Dickey Duff, Bond, and Brewer. On defense playing up, and Punch Imlach wants to have his sharpshooter, Bobby Pulford, on. And here's Bobby going into the circle to center off. He's going to face off against Donnie Marshall. Bonin very anxiously awaiting the expiration of his 2 seconds, and he'll be back on. 2-0 for Montreal over Toronto. Eddie Powers getting set. Back it comes, Pulford. Regan has it, Bonaz back on. Here's Regan sliding it to Armstrong. Armstrong back to Regan, going in for the shot. And it hit Marshall. Cleared over on the other side of Brewer. Brewer gives it to Armstrong, going right to the goal, and Plante comes up. Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs are doing everything but putting that puck in the net. That was their best, no doubt about it. Armstrong was set up beautifully. He walked in there, and Plante was falling from a short distance out, and Plante got in front of it.
Certainly the best save of the game, and perhaps the key save in this first period. Let's wait and see.
Now the Leafs again. It's Armstrong, number 10. Over it goes to Duff. Back it comes. Turner taking it. Armstrong is after him. Turner falls down in the corner on top of the puck, and the play is stopped. 2-0, Montreal 2, and Toronto nothing. Moore and Béliveau have scored for the Canadiens. 1:23 remaining in the penalty to Harvey. Back to Regan. He cleared it in front, and Johnson shoots it down the ice, and back for it is Dickey Duff along with Brewer. Brewer number 18. Brewer leaves it for Regan. He's coming out with Pulford, Duff, and Armstrong. Four of them at center. They flip it in. Now the puck cleared out by Johnson again. Brewer from the right wing cleared it to the corner. Plante out of the net, but Turner takes it to the other side of Provo. Provo to the line. Brewer failed to hold it in. Now it's Pulford on the left wing, shooting it into the Canadian zone. And we're nearing the 13th minute mark. Canadians again get it out over the line. Here's Brewer. It's off the boards. He kicked it in ahead. And Tom Johnson is there to get it. And Johnson scooped it down on the left side. And Bauer let it go off his skate behind the Leaf net. Number 18 in the corner is Brewer. And there are 25 seconds now remaining in the penalty to Harvey. At center ice, now veering over on the left side is Duff. He's across the line. Takes a shot that's rather weak to the side. Turner backhands it down the ice. Kelly is back. And right at this point, the Canadians putting up a solid defensive display. Now the Leafs trying it again. Here's Olmstead coming in, and he failed to set up Mihaljevic. Now it comes back, number 4 off the boards. That's Red Kelly. There's a shot. Harvey is back on. It's Kelly clearing it in toward the corner. Turner from Montreal fired at Harvey. Got his gloved hand in front of it. Harvey dumped the pass to Marshall. Over to Provo. Provo to the Toronto line. Jammed that shot against the leg of Stanley. Now it's Olmstead. A long pass failed to hit Mihaljevic. Slides down the ice, and the Toronto Maple Leafs will be called for icing. And we've played 14 minutes and 25 seconds in the first period. 2-0 the score. Montreal 2, Toronto nothing. Canadians every man up. Morris Richard, Henry Richard, and Moore, the forward line. It's Wilson, Edmondson, and James for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Back to Langlois at the point, and his shot is away wide. Stanley clearing a pass, intercepted. Langlois to Moore. Moore coming in with Henry Richard. Here's Moore getting in close. A backhand drive. The rebound cleared by Bauer with Horton going into assist. Centering pass hit Stanley, who cleared it off Edmondson's stick. Rolls into the Canadian zone. Harvey takes it around the net. Fired it on the boards. Henry Richard knocked down a rolling puck. He goes to the Toronto line. Back to Moore. And James took him out of the play neatly. It's Edmondson. As it knocked off his stick, gets it again. Cleared to James, who knocked it in over the ringside seat boards. The Canadians, aiming at an unprecedented fifth consecutive Stanley Cup, will, if they realize that objective, have won it 12 times. And the Maple Leafs, along with the Red Wings, have won it 7 times. The Leafs have been in the finals 15 times. Montreal Canadiens have been in the finals the last 10 years, and this marks the 17th time that they have been in the Stanley Cup Finals. Bobby Bond. Bobby Bond of the Toronto Maple Leafs getting the gate for interference. Number 21. Bond, who was a standout for the Leafs in the first game. He got one of their two goals.
Bond, 2 minutes for interference. A 15 minutes, 13 seconds. Toronto penalty, Bob LeBond, 2 minutes for interference. The time, 15 minutes and 13 seconds.
15 minutes and 13 seconds, the time of the interference penalty against Bond of Toronto. Canadians now have Beliveau, Moore, Bonin up front, Jeff Beyond, number five, who now has the puck deep in his own zone, is on one point, and Johnson will be on the other if and when they get into the Toronto zone. Here they are, four of them out over the line. Jeffrey on. He cleared it in on the left side. Bonnag going in, and Bauer knocked it to the corner. Beliveau back to Johnson. Off the board. Beliveau has it again. He centered it, and it's picked up by Stewart. And Stewart knocked it on the boards down the ice. The penalty killing specialist for Toronto, Stewart number 12 and Fulford number 20, are out there. As the Canadians start out, it's Moore with Beliveau, who takes the pass on the right side. Beliveau dropped it back to Dickie Moore. Here's Moore around the net, and he lost control of it. Toronto Maple Leafs Stanley hits Pulford with a drive out, and Pulford is coming down with Stewart. Over the line, a drop pass to Stewart, a shot right on, a hot shot. Moore fired it to Beliveau. Beliveau has it intercepted by Stanley. It's cleared back into the Canadian zone, and there are now 50 seconds remaining in the penalty to Bond. Beliveau coming out with Moore and Bonnage. Jeffrion's trailing. Beliveau shoots it to the corner. Olmstead is now on for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Beliveau getting it back to the line to Jeffrion. Jeffrion going in for the shot. Rebound off the boards. Out in front it comes. Kelly cleared it, but not out. Jeffrion faked the shot. Over to Moore. Into Jeffrion. He takes the shot. Here's Bonnage. Bonnage turning around. On the board. Still has it. Now he gives it to Beliveau. Beliveau has trouble with it. Back to Bonin. Over in front to Moore. Moore getting set. He shoots. And Bauer took it right off his stick as Stanley and Moore. Now it's Horton and Bonin. Beliveau and Stanley shoving. Moore was set up beautifully. And he backed up just a half stride trying to find the target. But Bauer beat him.
And as Moore backed up that half stride, Danny, Bauer stepped out about a full stride to reduce the angle. And he gave Dickie Moore very little of the net to hit. And of course, when the shot did come, Johnny flopped on it and halted play.
And there are 15 seconds remaining in the penalty to Bobby Bond. And he is indicating with putting up one hand, then the other, and another one to indicate 15 seconds. Canadians have Andre Pronovost, Phil Goyette, and Provo. And the Leafs with Olmstead and Kelly up front, and Stanley and Horton on defense. Back it goes. Olmstead scooping it ahead, and it just got over the end of the Canadian players' bench. And there you see Hec Dubois, the Canadian trainer, who tossed that new puck back on the ice. 2-0 the score. Montreal Leading Toronto 2-0. A high-flying puck knocked down, and Stanley cleared it down the ice. And there are now 4 seconds remaining in Bond's penalty. He is now back on. Andre Provo starting out, a pass to Provo on the right side. Provo over the line. The shot goes off Stanley, and Stanley racked up Provo after the shot to the side of the Leafs net. And Bauer holds on to it. Johnny Bauer and his wife, I think, perhaps gave about the best formula for his tremendous success at the age of 35 or 39. And it's been disputed whether he's 35 or 39. He has lots of talent, but she said the thing that makes Johnny great is will and determination. And he certainly is showing that in these, well, I suppose you could say final years of his career. This was probably his best year. There's a shot right on. Bauer grabbed it off Langlois. And Phil Goyette moves into the circle to face off against Bond, Bobby Bond. 2-0, Canadians are leading the Leafs. Back it goes. A shot by Langlois, cleared to Regan. Regan around the net. And there are 2 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the opening period. Here's Brewer starting out, and he's stopped by Phil Goyette. Goyette centers it in front, and Bond cleared it. Now it's Goyette again taking a shot. Brewer fell down. Finally, Armstrong cleared it to the line, but not out. And out it comes, and in, called on the offside.
And the pace has slowed down a little bit, Dan, following the pattern of the Thursday game, in which it started off so quickly, Canadians taking a 3-goal lead and then falling into a shell. They have a 2-0 lead here tonight, and the game has slowed down a little bit.
It started out at that very quick, fast tempo. And now, as we have 2 minutes remaining in the second period, slowing perceptibly. Up on the right side, it's Horton. He runs into Langlois, bowls Langlois over. Horton takes the shot, and he hit Harvey. Harvey dashes around the net to get away from Regan, spins from the corner. And now Duff after him. Harvey gets it out over the line, deflected by Horton, actually, to center, and it's Stanley. Stanley, a left-wing pass. Checking is getting close, and that's one of the reasons why it has slowed down. Here is Goyette, jammed under the play by Horton and Stanley. Stanley, number 26, a right wing pass to Armstrong. Armstrong coming in, he's working it on the right side. And he couldn't get that good shot away as he was being hurried by Harvey. So Armstrong did a lot of sort of ad-libbing down on the right wing. He'd lose it and pick it up again, and finally, cleverly, put it between the skates of Langlois. A minute and 22 seconds. Armstrong tied up this time by Henry Richard. Regan goes in. Now the Rocket is jamming away, trying to get possession. And a minute and 13 seconds left. The weather in Montreal tonight, wet snow, good hockey weather. But if you're looking for that very early spring, you wouldn't like it. Talbot around the net, coming out with Rocket Richard. It's fired on the boards, and Stanley back for Toronto. Now we have just about 1 minute remaining in the opening period. Two to nothing the score, Montreal leading it. And here's Tom Johnson from outside the line taking the long shot. Armstrong from the corner being watched by Moore. Moore takes it away, loses it. Now Horton got away from Henry Richard. He's at center, left wing pass to Dickey Duff. Duff going in over the other side. There's a shot by Horton. And Pont got in front of it. Pont has pulled off some fine saves in this period. 29 seconds there. This is Regan. He scores! Larry Regan knocking down that high pass, and he drilled it. Past Jacques Pont from about 15 feet out. Larry Regan scoring for the Toronto Maple Leafs to put them right back in the hockey game here in the final seconds of the opening period. 2-1, Canadians 2 and the Leafs 1. So Regan never wasted emotion.
As he stayed, Armstrong, a duck. at 19 minutes 32 seconds. Toronto goal scored by Larry Regan, assist Armstrong and Duff. The time, 19 minutes and 32 seconds.
19:32, and now there are 8 seconds remaining as the Leafs clear it down the ice. Doug Harvey has it before it goes over the goal line. Harvey stopping behind the net, and now the period is over. A breakaway for Jeffrion, but the period is over. And in that period, Canadians outshot the Toronto Maple Leafs 11-10.
2-1 in favor of the Canadians after a period. Ward Cornell is standing by with some special guests.
With our first guest, our analyst for the NHL Final Series, Milt Schmidt of the Boston Bruins. Well, Milt, what'd you think?
Ward, you can tell that the Toronto Maple Leafs certainly had a talking to by somebody, because they certainly have changed their style of play from the game Thursday night. Thursday night they were coming back with their wings and maybe sending one man in to forecheck, and tonight, why, all three forwards are going in there to forecheck, and they've got those Canadians hanging on right at the present time. And it looks as though that if the Toronto Maple Leafs can continue to forecheck the way they have that first period, they're going to give the Montreal Canadiens a lot of trouble. They might be very fortunate in having a one-goal lead at the present time, because Plante had to come up with two tremendous split saves, and also a great save on Armstrong when the Toronto Maple Leafs had a man to advantage. So if it hadn't been for Plante, why, this game could very easily be tied up right now, or Toronto maybe a goal ahead.
Looks as though Punch Imlach is using an extra line tonight, or using that fourth line a bit more.
He's using it more tonight than he did the last game, perhaps to conserve a lot of energy. Maybe the game might go on into overtime. You never can tell in these playoff games. And, of course, that's quite a capable line. And if he wants to raise a little bit of trouble out there, you might say, why, those three of them, they can raise a lot of trouble out there.
Thanks very much, Milt Schmidt.
You're watching Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV. Goal by Larry Regan has cut the margin to 2-1 in favor of the Canadians after a period. Bobby Haggard is our special guest, the longtime trainer of the Toronto Maple Leafs, and a gentleman that's utilized a bit on the fourth line with the Leafs in this era is a guy by the name of Jerry James. And I know you have some very fond memories of this guy, Bobby, but he would play in the Canadian Football League with the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, and then when their season was over, he would join the Leafs. What kind of shape would he have been in after a hard football season to take over playing hockey?
Well, first of all, he was young. Secondly, he was tough. And, I mean, he was a man amongst men. He originally came to Marlborough Juniors when he was 16, 17 years of age. His father, Dynamite Eddie James, was the most valuable player in the CFL. And so he came with a good hockey background, but a much better football player. And in junior hockey, he just dominated everyone when he was on the ice. He was a man amongst teenagers when he played junior hockey. And the deal was with the Leafs, he came to camp, and there was interest in him. They thought he could be an NHL player, but deep down his first love was pro football, and he could immediately step in and be a first string starter with the Blue Bombers. Mm-hmm. Whereas if he came with the Leafs, he might have to go to our farm team in Rochester. He may make it, they may bring him up. So he elected football first, hockey second. And so Conn Smythe liked him, and the management liked him, and all the players loved him. And so when his football season would be over, he would come. I think he won the most valuable Canadian player, I think at least twice, mm-hmm. playing for the Bombers, and he played in the Grey Cup. And but boy, was he tough.
Now you have a story of his junior career and a little incident up in Quebec.
Well, it... In, I guess, around 53, 54-ish, the OHA, it was called then, made a deal with the Quebec Junior League, and we would play an interlocking schedule, and to bring some more excitement to the game, because eventually the OHA winner played the Quebec winner to go to the Memorial Cup. And so we'd make a trip. All the teams would make one trip through Quebec. The Quebec teams would have to make two because there were so many teams in the OHA. So we would play in Montreal against the Junior Canadiens, then the Trois-Rivières Reds, they were called, and then the Quebec Frontenacs. And there was a new team in Jonquière, Quebec, which was way up near Chicoutimi, and it was like a four-hour bus ride from Quebec. So we played one game up there. And it was
nice and balmy, too.
Oh, it was wonderful spring weather. It was only 48 below. And it was so cold, they didn't have a refrigeration in the arena, and they opened the doors. And I mean, and that's what...
Great ice.
Froze the goal. It was terrific ice. So anyway, we played them, and they had one player, and he was kind of their local strong-arm guy. But anyway, by the end of the first period, we were up 5-0, and it wasn't even a contest. But we did have a good team. And by the end of the second period, it was 8 or 9, and the fans were yelling for this strong man to come out and play. And for finally, the third period, they put him out. Jerry James went across the ice, challenged him, cold cocked him, beat you know what out of him. He lasted about 2 minutes, and that was the end of the superstar. We end up winning 12-1. We come out to get on the bus to go back to Chicoutimi, and 6 of the windows are broken.
Oh, no.
And the bus, and it's 48 below zero.
We got a
4-hour ride back. And then, ironically, when John Kier made their tour through southern Ontario, Bruiser wasn't with them.
he caught a little Jerry James flu, did he?
Yeah.
He was an interesting character and
a tough
individual.
But he was a terrific, everybody loved him, and he loved to play. And he played for Runnymede Collegiate when he came here, because all junior players had to go to high school. And he played for Runnymede, and he just demolished football in Toronto. I mean, he was so good.
Great. Jerry James, some stories from Bobby Haggard as the Maple Leafs trail the Montreal Canadiens 2-1. Game 2 of the Stanley Cup Final, April 9th, 1960. This is Molson Canadian Sunday Night Classics on Leafs TV.
The Leafs, we have Stewart, Fulford, and Olmsted. Langlois and Harvey on defense for Montreal, and for the Leafs it's Horton and Stanley. And now the second period officially underway. Olmsted back to Horton on the right side to Stewart, and the Leafs clear it in, and they race in after it with Plante out of the net. Doug Harvey turns. He's knocked down by Bobby Pulford, recovered. The puck is by Langlois off to the corner. Stewart backhands it in front, and Harvey sends Beliveau away. Beliveau is down over the line with Jeffrey on. Beliveau shoots right on, and the rebound cleared by Bauer. Left wing pass to Olmsted, knocked away from him by Jeffrey on, recovered for the Leafs, cleared on the other side. Stewart playing it back into Horton. Horton to Stanley. Stanley rolled it ahead to Pulford on the left side to Olmsted. Olmsted going in, fakes the shot, turns around, back to Stanley. Stanley got it in front. Stewart takes the shot, a bouncing puck. Olmsted still has it. Olmsted with Jeffrey on against him. It's kicked to the side of the net. Into the corner on the boards is Olmsted. Back to the point to Stanley. He winds up with a shot, and it's tipped out over the line by Langlois. Stanley on the left side. At center for Toronto to Pulford. He cleared it in. Harvey ahead to Beliveau. He's down with Jeffrey on. Beliveau takes the hard drive from outside the line. And Johnny Bauer taking no chances on a big rebound on that. He held onto it. The radio broadcast of this game tonight is being piped into the room at the RCAF station at Cold Lake, Alberta, where 500 young players and their fathers are attending a minor hockey league banquet after the game, this game. They'll show the film of last year's Stanley Cup, so they're seeing a lot of hockey out there tonight, and we hope, young fellows, that they are feeding you well. Face off to the left of Bauer. Away. Beliveau is down over the line with Jeffrey on. Beliveau shoots right on, and the rebound cleared by Bauer. Left wing pass to Olmsted. Knocked away from him by Jeffrey on, recovered for the Leafs. Cleared on the other side. Stewart playing it back into Horton. Horton to Stanley. Stanley rolled it ahead to Pulford on the left side to Olmsted. Olmsted going in, fakes the shot, turns around, back to Stanley. Stanley got it in front. Stewart takes a shot, a bouncing puck. Olmsted still has it. Olmsted with Jeffrey on against him. It's kicked to the side of the net. Into the corner on the boards is Olmsted. Back to the point to Stanley. He winds up with a shot, and it's tipped out over the line by Langlois. Stanley on the left side. At center for Toronto to Pulford. He cleared it in. Harvey ahead to Beliveau. He's down with Jeffrey on. Beliveau takes the hard drive from outside the line. And Johnny Bauer taking no chances on a big rebound on that. He held on to it. The radio broadcast of this game tonight is being piped into the room at the RCAF station at Cold Lake, Alberta, where 500 young players and their fathers are attending a minor hockey league banquet after the game, this game. They'll show the film of last year's Stanley Cup, so they're seeing a lot of hockey out there tonight, and we hope, young fellows, that they are feeding you well. Face off to the left of Bauer. Henry and Maurice Richard with Dick Moore for the Canadians. Red Kelly, Mahovlich, and Edmondson for Toronto. 2-1 the score with the Canadians leading. Edmondson, a left wing pass to number 27. That is Mahovlich at center. A long shot deflected at the side, and Talbot for Montreal dumped it ahead in among the spectators. So this period, and there's a real scramble for a souvenir. This period is starting up pretty much the same as the first ended. A slower pace than the hockey that characterized the first 12 or 13 minutes of this hockey game. Now the Leafs with every man up. It goes to Edmondson, a backhand drive, and rolls in front, and Kelly just failed to get it. Here's Brewer at the point, a shot, he's wide. Kelly centered it right in front, and it hopped over Mahovlich's stick. Here's Rocket Richard, up with Henry Richard, who takes the pass. Over the line, it's flipped in front, and some nice back checking by Edmondson. Edmondson coming out for the Toronto Maple Leafs. At center, a left wing pass. Mahovlich couldn't get it. Lund cleared it on the boards. Canadians are starting back. Here's Tom Johnson ahead to Henry Richard. He couldn't get it, and it went to Bauer's doorstep. 2-1 the score in the second period. Now Dickie Moore, he centers it in front. Henry Richard couldn't see it. The rocket was tied up. Mahovlich went right across Bauer's doorstep. A pass goes to Kelly. Kelly is coming down. He's over the line. A drop pass to Edmondson. He couldn't get his shot away. Edmondson backhands it. Here's Mahovlich faking the shot. And it went off Kelly and went across the goal mouth. It's Pocket Richard in over the Toronto line. A pass to Talbot. He's going in a goal. He shoots. Bauer is down. And Bauer making the save on the short side.
One thing that has been very noticeable about Bauer tonight, Danny, he is flopping on every puck that's at all possible for him to do so. He's not taking any chances on rebounds down around the goal crease. He's just stopping and flopping, and Carl Brewer there and Captain George Armstrong probably telling him to keep it up.
It's Bill Goyette on with Andre Pronovo and Provo for Montreal. Duff, Armstrong, and Regan for the Leafs. That is the line that has scored. Langlois intercepts the pass, cleared it in. Now Bill Goyette goes to the corner. He's knocked down by Horton. Horton has it on the board. Now he still has it for Toronto. On the right side to Armstrong. Back to Horton. Horton is starting out into center ice to Regan. Regan coming down with Armstrong. They shoot it into the corner. Off the boards it goes. Provo slapped it back. Duff fired it on the boards. Here's Regan over on the other side. He tips it to Armstrong. Back it goes to Horton. Horton lost it. And he had to go out over the line to get it. Horton off the boards to Stanley. Stanley shooting it in. Langlois, a pass. Andre Pronovo, he couldn't get it. Regan starting back, fired it in. Big Armstrong is going in for the shot, and he couldn't get it away as he was being tied up by Phil Goyette. There's a pass over on the left wing at center, and Horton fired it back into the Canadian zone. And we're nearing the fourth minute mark in this second period. Here's Horton getting it at the point. He winds up for the shot. It's kicked out by Plante, and that low drive was right on. Langlois for Canadians, jammed in on the board, picked up. A pass goes to Phil Goyette from Pronovo. The shot wide. Now it's Regan covering up in the corner to the left of Bauer. Canadians get it clear. Here's Provo. Back it goes. Doug Harvey is closing in for the shot. Knocked down by Stanley. Ahead to Dickie Duff. Here's Duff cutting in on goal. He's trying to get in front. And he tried to slide it in front with Plante stopping it. Armstrong taking Harvey in the corner on the boards. Bill Goyette starting out with Provo 14. He has it. In on the Toronto line. A flip shot goes off the knee of Stanley. Bobby Pulford playing it on the boards to number 9. Duff cleared it down the left side. And the Toronto Maple Leafs will be called for icing as Jeffrion touched it. And back they go to the left of Bauer in the north. Bert Olmsted, number 16. Gated out of position now. Brewer moves from the faceoff spot back outside the circle. He's coming in to do the honors against Beliveau. 2-1 for the Canadians over the Leafs. It's cleared. Beliveau racing in. Bauer fired it. Now Beliveau has it. Back it comes to Talbot going in for the shot. And Bobby Bond stopped it. Here come the Leafs led by Pulford. Broken up. Recovered by Olmstead. Olmstead's passed up by Jeffrion. Jeffrion is going in on the right side. He shoots it. And Bauer had trouble with that one as he finally dove down and got the rebound. Face off to the right of Bauer. And we play 5 minutes and 5 seconds. The next game in the series will be played at the Gardens in Toronto. On Tuesday night, and the fourth at the Gardens in Toronto Thursday night. Here's Talbot closing in for a shot. Jeffrion couldn't get it. Jeffrion takes a swipe at it. Leafs clearing it. Olmstead is starting out. A pass. And Stewart failed to pick it up. Bonin rifles it back into the Leafs zone. In behind the net. Bobby Bond, left wing pass to Brewer. Brewer to Olmstead, 16 to Pulford. Pulford down to the Canadian line. He's going in, takes the shot, and Plante just dropped it to the side. 2-1 for the Canadians. Beliveau leaving it for Jeffrion. Jeffrion at center ice. He goes to the Toronto line, winds up, a hard shot right on. But Bauer had it taped and had his stick there. Now Pulford bodied. Jeffrion working the side. He centered it out, and Olmstead was there to get it. Olmstead clearing it out. Here's Bobby Pulford. Firing it ahead, Talbot down after it, and the Toronto Maple Leafs call for icing as Talbot almost lost his balance with Pulford coming in after him. Scoring in the hockey game, Moore and Beliveau for Montreal and Regan for Toronto, and all the scoring has taken place in the first period, in which Toronto outshot Montreal 11-10. Henry and Morris Richard with Moore. Mahovlich, there's a shot. Bauer got a stick on it. Mahovlich is on with Kelly and Edmondson. A pass to center ice by Mahovlich, grabbed by Moore, who fired it back to the Toronto line, and there's Stanley. Stanley over on the other side to Edmondson. The big boy down on the right side to Kelly, off his skate. Kelly lost it, now he's back after Henry Richard. Moore picked it up, going up with the rocket. He's over the line. Moore still has it, fired it in off the boards. Moore gets it and couldn't center it out. Now it's Horton, ahead to Edmondson, into center ice with Kelly and Mahovlich in over the Canadian line. Here's Edmondson clearing it, and Rocket Richard knocked it back to the corner. Langlois around the net. He's turned around by Mahovlich. Rocket Richard lost his balance, fell down, and here's Henry Richard to the Toronto line. In on the left side, he dumped it over to Dickie Moore, roaring right in, and Moore couldn't knock it down. Toronto Leafs in their own zone. Mahovlich right in front. Now he gets away from Henry Richard, down to the Canadian line, stick handling neatly. He tries to get in by Langlois. He couldn't, and Harvey cleared it on the boards. Here's Moore to Rocket, to Billy Hickey, who is out on right wing. And Hickey has come out there on that line with Moore and Henry Richard. But the Canadians were just in the process of making a complete change with Backstrom, Hickey, and Marshall coming on. 7 minutes and 22 seconds have gone by in the middle period. Regan, Armstrong, and Duff for the Leafs. Johnson in his own zone, working up on the right side.